So we're here at the Marin Institute, which is short for the Maritime Research Institute, the Netherlands, where we're conducting new scale model tests right here in what is known as the offshore basin. It's one of their largest basins. It's 40 meters long and 40 meters wide. It can be up to 10 meters deep. They have a movable floor. And in here, what you see is a 1:10 scale model, which means that this would represent a 120 meter long section of the bigger cleanup system. And the purpose of these tests is really to understand the forces and the behavior of the screen that's below the pipe. So underneath the floater, we have this 3 meter deep screen, the purpose of which is to stop the submerged plastic and to make sure that even if there are waves and the pipe isn't following the water perfectly, that still we can capture that plastic. But during the prototypes, we saw last year that this is one of the most critical elements of the cleanup system. So even though we're already launching the cleanup system in a few months, we really want to do this extra scale model testing right now as a final validation to make sure that the forces that we measure here aren't higher than the design loads for which we have designed the screen. And we're testing really two conditions. One is the towing configuration. So what does the screen do while we're towing it to the Great Pacific Garbage Patch? And the other condition is the operational condition, where really we have current from the front, so basically the system as it would function in the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. So of course we've been doing a lot of scale model tests over the past few years, but the big difference is that right now the design of the system is really just different. Back then we still had that very flexible air-filled floaters. Now we of course migrated to this stiffer HDPE pipe as a floater, which of course changes the whole behavior of the system. And now we're going to see some waves. So you can see it going up and down like a water snake. So these are relatively steep waves. And even in those conditions, we still see that the barrier is behaving quite well. What we chose for with our design is a floater pipe that's flexible enough to be able to follow waves like this, but is still stiff enough to remain open in this U shape. So it's kind of a trade-off. The stiffer it becomes, the bigger the system can become, but the less well it's able to follow the waves. And it seems like we have a pretty good trade-off there.